Please be seated. Good morning. My name is Catherine Rand, and I am privileged to serve as Dean of the School of Law. It is my pleasure to welcome you to the spring commencement ceremony for the University of North Dakota School of Law, class of 2016. Thank you for being here this morning to mark this auspicious occasion and to join us in recognizing the collective achievements of our graduates. Let me begin by introducing the members of the platform party. Don Morton, Vice Chair of the North Dakota State Board of Higher Education. Ed Schaefer, President of the University of North Dakota. Carla Pratt, our distinguished commencement speaker. Wayne Swisher, Dean of the UND School of Graduate Studies. Brad Myers, the School of Law's Associate Dean for Academic Affairs, and Carmen Williams, the Interim University Co-Registrar. And in our audience today are two very special guests, the next president of the University of North Dakota, the Honorable Mark Kennedy, and his wife, Debbie. We are delighted to have you join us in celebrating our graduates today. I'd also like to introduce some members of our law school community who will play important roles in this morning's commencement ceremony. Each year, the graduating class selects the commencement proctor who has the honor of reading the name of each graduate as he or she crosses the stage, and the commencement hooders who have the honor of placing an academic hood lined with the colors of the University of North Dakota on each graduate. This year, the class of 2016 selected Bradley Parrish, our Assistant Dean for Student Life, to serve as proctor. Dean Parrish has been part of our graduates' lives since the first day of their first year orientation. The class of 2016 also selected to serve as hooders Professor Michael McGinnis and Julia Ernst, who, along with our other faculty, have been teachers, advisors, and mentors to our graduates. Throughout the auditorium today are our commencement ceremony marshals wearing distinctive green robes. The marshals are students selected from our rising second and third year classes based on academic excellence. And the grand marshal, who will assist in the diploma ceremony later in our program, is Mary Batchelor. During this morning's commencement ceremony, the degree of Juris Doctor will be formally conferred on each of our graduates. The formality of this centuries-old tradition, the academic regalia of our platform party and graduates, and the pomp and circumstance that surround this morning's ceremony are appropriate to the occasion. This morning, we mark the transition of our graduates from aspiring attorneys to members of the legal profession. We recognize and honor the class of 2016 and their accomplishments, and we acknowledge those who have made the present and future successes of our graduates possible. First, the people who have dedicated their professional careers to the University of North Dakota School of Law, our talented and accomplished faculty, our highly capable staff, and our tireless administrators. From admissions to placement, from orientation to commencement, from administrative law to workers' compensation, and everything between, our faculty and staff are responsible for the excellent program of legal education we offer at the School of Law. Even more, Their good and generous spirit ensures that the School of Law is a welcoming and supportive environment for all our students. I ask all of the faculty and staff of the School of Law to stand so that we may acknowledge your role in the success of the class of 2016. And there is another group of people who deserve credit for their role in seeing each of our graduates to and through this day. Graduates, over the past 3 years, each of you has had friends and family, cheerleaders and confidants, shoulders to cry on, and arms to raise you up. Some of those people are here with us today, and others are with us in spirit. I ask our graduates to take a moment to hold in your hearts your loved ones who are here in spirit. And many of your loved ones are here in person this morning. Mothers, fathers, grandparents, you have given our graduates roots to keep them firmly grounded and wings to let them soar. Mothers, fathers, grandparents, please stand so that we may thank you. And spouses and partners of our graduates, you have given your love and support by choice during this 3-year-long test of your relationship. And the children of our graduates who are so proud of their moms and dads, please, spouses, partners, and kids, stand so that we may honor you as well. The class of 2016 thanks you, and all of us at the School of Law thank you for sharing with us this incredible group of people. We are pleased to have State Board of Higher Education Vice Chair Don Morton with us today. Mr. Morton brings extensive business experience and organizational management expertise to his role in guiding higher education in our state. I invite him to deliver greetings on behalf of the State Board.
President Ed Schaefer, Dean Catherine Rand, faculty, staff, family, friends, and most importantly, School of Law grads, congratulations. Well done. Thank you. As stated, I am here to represent the State Board of Higher Ed. In preparation for this event, the university system was kind enough to write a few remarks for me, and I will return that kindness and not deliver those remarks. Instead, I will put on my virtual Microsoft cap and deliver a few thoughts from the corporate world that may be or may not be helpful, but let's give it a try. Graduates, make a commitment to innovation and risk-taking. It takes great humility to be an innovator. It takes great humility to be an innovative organization. It takes humility to realize that you may not be the smartest person in the room. It takes humility to challenge long-held assumptions that you hold dear. Innovation is very much a team sport. Working together works. We can say this is mine and be good, or we can say this is ours and be better. Working together not only brings out the best in all of us, it brings out the best in each of us. And innovation really begins when the conversation shifts to how great our team, our organization, our university can be. It begins, and it takes great humility and courage to say, let's improve, we can do better. If you are good, why not be better? If you're better, why not be the very best? Yes, it takes humility to be an innovative organization. Someone gave me some advice many years ago. They said, if at first you do succeed, try to hide your astonishment. I've been at Microsoft for over 15 years, and before that I was a football coach, and my wife was always very helpful in keeping me humble. When I was at the University of Wisconsin, we had a big upset win over Ohio State. I went home after that game feeling pretty good, and I said to my wife, Sue, how many great coaches are there in the country? I mean, how many of us, really? 9, 10? She looked me straight in the eye and said, one less than you think. Graduates, make a commitment to your own self-education and your own individual development. And why is that important? Because there is a new game in town, and that new game is all about human capital and a global information-based economy. Today's information-based economy lets businesses create vast shareholder wealth with very little financial capital. Human capital leverage is so much better leverage in creating wealth. Uber is a great example. The best companies, the best law firms, the best universities realize that they desperately need talented people, talent of every type, technical talent, legal talent, business acumen, and the list goes on. Yes, there is a new game in town, and that new game is all about human capital and an information-based global economy. And our options are to learn this new game, the rules of that new game, the roles, how the rewards are distributed, what are the best practices, or we can continue practicing our present skills and become the best players in a game that is no longer being played. So my message today is very simple. Trust people, embrace change, take some chances, think and talk about mission and vision, and make a commitment to your own self-development education. Make a commitment to the idea that one person can make a difference, and make a commitment to being that one person. Three things to think about. The greatest mistake, not trying. The greatest day today, May 7th, 2016, greatest day ever, enjoy it. And the greatest joy is celebrating success together. And graduates, we look forward to you celebrating a lot of success together. Enjoy this moment, enjoy this day. Thank you, and best wishes always.
Thank you, Don, for being with us today. We appreciate the State Board's support of higher education in North Dakota and your support of the next generation of attorneys who will serve our state and our nation. I am so pleased that the class of 2016 has chosen as its commencement speaker Carla Pratt. Dean Pratt serves as the Associate Dean for Academic Affairs and Educational Equity at Penn State's Dickinson School of Law. Since 2012, she has served as an Associate Justice for the Supreme Court of the Standing Rock Sioux Tribe in Fort Yates, North Dakota. The court decides appeals that involve tribal members or those who do business with tribal members in cases related to tribal criminal law, family law, business law, and constitutional law. As an academic administrator concerned about diversity in higher education and in law school in particular, Dean Pratt has worked to enhance diversity at Penn State University at both the law school and the university level. She has served on the University President's Commission for LGBT Equity and is the recipient of the law school's Philip McConaughey Award for outstanding achievement in diversity-related work. Dean Pratt also engages in scholarship, examining racial diversity in law school and the legal profession, including her recent book, The End of the Pipeline. The book challenges the assumption that people of color experience law school and entry into the legal profession in a colorblind or post-racial way. It is particularly meaningful to have Dean Pratt speak at this year's commencement, as next month, the School of Law will host, along with our State Bar Association, the president of the American Bar Association, Paulette Brown, who has made diversity in the legal profession the focus of her presidency. When we asked our students why, out of all possible commencement speakers, they wished to have Dean Pratt address their class, their friends, and their families on the occasion of their law school graduation, here is what they told me. The law school is proud to have hosted many state and federal court judges from North Dakota as commencement speakers in the past several years. However, we have never had a justice from a tribal court speak to our graduating class. We believe that because of the history of the University of North Dakota and its proud legacy of graduating many Native American lawyers and doctors, it is time for our graduating class to recognize the distinguished tribal jurists who serve North Dakota's Indian tribes. And we are especially excited at the prospect of hearing remarks from Justice Pratt because of her national recognition as a voice for inclusion in the legal and academic community. Well said, class of 2016. Please join me in welcoming Dean Pratt to the lectern for her commencement address.
Thank you for that kind introduction, Dean Rand. I have to say that it is truly an honor to be invited to address the University of North Dakota School of Law's 2016 graduating class. I want to thank Dean Catherine Rand and the UND Law faculty, and most of all, the class of 2016 for the invitation to address you today. I would also like to thank Dean Parrish and Beth Moe for being such wonderful hosts and coordinating the logistics for getting me here. It's not easy to get to Grand Forks. Graduates, you know your accomplishment today was not achieved alone, but in partnership with your family and friends who supported you during the 3 years that you were here in law school. And so I too, as Dean Rand, would like to congratulate all of those children and aunts and uncles and spouses and friends and grandparents and parents and siblings, because today belongs to you as well. Graduates, would you please join me in standing and applauding your family and friends for their support? Thank you, class of 2016. I knew I could count on you. So when invited to give a commencement speech, the first emotion that you have is complete humility and I felt overwhelming honor to be invited. And then I felt lots of dread. What could I possibly have to say that the esteemed faculty at UND Law has not already said to this group of talented, bright young minds? And so I thought about all the things that I could do, and then I became a law professor, and I said, I really need to give them one last lesson. But don't worry, I'm mindful that I'm all that stands between you and getting your law degree handed to you today, so I'm going to be quick. In all my years of being a law professor, 15 years of sitting through commencement speeches, there's one complaint I've never heard, and that is, you know, the speech was just too short. On behalf of Chief Justice of the Standing Rock Sioux Tribal Supreme Court, Bradley Peterson, who is also a UND Law School alum, and Associate Justice Dwight Cook, we thank you for the privilege to stand here today and address you as a member of the Standing Rock Sioux Supreme Court. Serving in that role has taught me a few things that I'd like to share with you today. And the overarching point from today's lesson that I'd like for you to take away and remember is that despite your graduation today, you're not finished with learning. The practice of law is an exercise in lifelong learning. So today is the beginning in a new journey of learning. When I joined the Standing Rock Sioux Supreme Court, I viewed it as an opportunity to serve, to give back, to pay it forward, as you younger people might say. I knew that most Native nations do not have enough tribal members who are lawyers to populate their courts with judges. So I viewed my contribution as a Supreme Court justice as a means to serve and help meet this need. What I didn't anticipate is what I would gain through this service. So today I'd like to share with you four lessons that I've learned through serving as a justice on the court. The people of Standing Rock are members of the Dakota and Lakota nations, and with the help of my colleague, Justice Dwight Cook, who is an enrolled member at Standing Rock, I have learned to infuse Lakota tradition and values into the exercise of judging. And I want to emphasize that I have learned the values, not the language. So if I mispronounce some Lakota words today, please forgive me. The first lesson that I've learned is to implement the value of Wachentoknaka. Wachentoknaka is the Lakota word for generosity. To be generous means to contribute to the well-being of your community by sharing and giving freely. Many of you, I've noted, have already done that in law school through your pro bono work and your devotion to community. You have started on this journey of generosity. All of you chose to attend and now graduate from a law school with a program of legal education that instills a strong commitment to community and public service. So I urge you not to lose sight of this value in the quest to advance your career. And I apologize for doing the Marco Rubio, but I can't get through a speech without water these days. Sharing your legal education with others through pro bono work, service on nonprofit boards, or public interest legal work will benefit our society in immeasurable ways. But the personal growth and benefit it will bring to you is also immeasurable. Remember this Lakota saying, what you give away, you keep, and what you keep, you lose. So remember that to enrich yourself, you must be generous. And although I haven't asked Dean Rand about this, I'm sure she would agree that when you're off practicing law as a successful attorney, you can exercise your generosity anytime you like by writing a check to UND Law School. The second lesson that I learned from my time on tribal court is to be mindful of Wotakuye, the Lakota word for kinship. When I first observed a tribal court proceeding, I had an unfamiliar experience there. I had been a litigator in Philadelphia prior to joining academia, so I had been in court many times. But tribal court was different. The judge seemed overly respectful and compassionate toward the litigants. He imposed little social distance between himself and the litigants. It was almost as if they were kin. I knew that the tribal community was small, fewer than 9,000 people, but I never expected this level of familiarity in the courtroom. Most of the individuals who come before tribal court do not have the means to hire a lawyer, so they are what we call pro se litigants. They're often unfamiliar with the court's rules and procedures, and so from the comfort of the position of jurist, it would be easy for me to find fault in the parties that come before the court, and it would be easy to dismiss many of their claims for lack of conformity to court rules or failure to state a claim under the legal, technical manner in which a claim should be stated. But rather than enforce strict adherence to court rules and dismiss pro se litigants from courts, tribal courts approach pro se litigants with dignity and compassion. They approach them with the same dignity and compassion they would show their own kinfolk. So a person who's bringing an appeal, who inartfully states her appeal, claiming that the trial judge treated her unfairly, is not simply denied and dismissed. Instead, we read that pro se application with an interpretive eye, respectful of the litigant's claim, filtering it through our legal training and knowledge that we were privileged to receive. The petition to appeal asserting a litigant was treated unfairly by the trial court is interpreted as a due process appeal, which we subsequently hear on the merits. In this way, tribal court has helped me to remember that there is a person behind every claim, a person who is trusting the court not only to be fair, but to be compassionate and helpful. As a practicing lawyer or judge, you will be presented with many matters, and I urge you to have compassion for the people involved in those matters and honor their dignity when deciding how you will handle their matter. Treat them as if they were your own kinfolk. Unless, of course, your family is like mine and they drive you crazy, in which you should treat them like the kinfolk you wish you had. Just kidding, Mom. Tomorrow's Mother's Day. The third lesson I have learned is to have wachindaka, which means fortitude. I suspect that each of you has a healthy dose of fortitude already, or you wouldn't have been able to make it through law school. But some of you have had pretty smooth sailing so far. You were successful in completing high school, which wasn't a difficult challenge for you, and then on to college. And while law school was a challenge, you're here today, and so you've achieved it. You may not have had many failures or challenges at this point, but as the parents and grandparents in this audience will tell you, just keep on living, because those challenges are going to come. They're going to come in your career, and they're going to come in your life. To have fortitude is to have the confidence in yourself. It requires patience. Things won't always happen on your timetable. It requires perseverance. You won't always succeed on the first attempt, or even the second, although I'm confident every graduate here is going to pass the bar on the first attempt. But when you fail at something, and I say when, because if you are achieving goals, if you are working toward growing, you are going to fail at something. So when it happens, just remember that failure is a stepping stone on the path to success. So don't be afraid of it. Embrace it. Fortitude also requires mental strength. Remember, whatever the challenge is, it will pass. So just hang in there. The final lesson I want to share with you is to exercise waksape in all that you do. Waksape is the Lakota word for humility and wisdom. You've gained a lot of knowledge in law school. Use it wisely. Wisdom exists at the intersection of knowledge, maturity, and experience. I would assert that one's actual wisdom is inversely proportional to one's perceived wisdom. The more we realize what we don't know, the closer we are to attaining true wisdom. Consequently, the pursuit and attainment of wisdom is a lifelong endeavor. So try not to view today's achievement as the end of learning, but rather as a milestone in the journey toward wisdom. Professional wisdom means being able to incorporate the values of the legal profession into your identity. Will you keep information confidential when the client entrusts you with it, even if it's really juicy gossip, or will you be tempted to Snapchat about it with your closest friend? Will you be able to respect and honor all persons who come into contact with our justice system, even those who are accused of heinous crimes, even the rude adversary who clearly didn't learn to implement the lessons that I've shared here today? Remember, if you fail, and if you curse at an obnoxious adversary, just go back to lesson 3 and try again. Wisdom comes in time. I didn't learn all of these lessons at once, and I didn't learn them all in one context. I learned them over time in various contexts, serving on the court. And these values probably sound familiar to you, but what's challenging is the implementation of these values in the practice of law. And that is what I learned how to do by serving on tribal court. I'm confident that each of you have the generosity, the compassion, the fortitude, and the wisdom to make a difference. And I'm excited to see what you will do as members of the legal profession here in North Dakota and beyond. Thank you, thank you, thank you for choosing to devote your talents to the legal profession. Congratulations, UND class of 2016. You did it. Let's celebrate. Thank you.
Thank you, Dean Pratt. You stand as a role model and inspiration for all of us, and we thank you for your work in our state as well as in legal education. And now, we will turn to the formal conferring of the degrees. I'll ask President Schaefer to come to the lectern.
The candidates for the Juris Doctor degrees in the School of Law will be presented by Dean Catherine Rand.
Candidates, please rise. President Schaefer, these candidates have completed all the requirements for the degree of Juris Doctor. I therefore have the great honor of presenting them to you for the conferring of this degree.
The candidate for the Master of Business Administration degree will be presented by Dean Wayne Swisher.
President Schaefer, as indicated in the program, one of these candidates has completed all the requirements for the degree of Master of Business Administration in the combined Juris Doctor MBA degree. I have the honor of presenting that candidate to you for the conferring of that degree.
Upon the recommendation of the faculty and by the authority of the North Dakota State Board of Higher Education, I confer upon you the degree of Juris Doctor, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto. For you has completed the combined Juris Doctor MBA program, I also confer upon you the degree of Master of Business Administration.
Thank you, President Schaefer. As our proctors, hooders, and grand marshal take their positions, please join me in acknowledging the significant academic achievement of our newest Juris Doctors. Graduates, please be seated. When the candidates marshal indicates to you, please come forward for your hooding and the receipt of your diplomas.
Olufemi Oyewumi Adisa. Alexandra Argenti. Nicholas P. Baker. Marin Kirsten Bardal. Jessica Sarah Bombach. Joshua Eli Burke. Brent Thomas Bedeker. Washington the third. Chelsea E. Brown. Thomas J. Burkhard. Nicholas Christensen. Caroline Patricia Christie. Lucas Wade Croker. Stephen Dirth. Brant Michael Dewar. Alicia Duran. Cassandra Ann Eno. Evenson. Robert W. Frazier. James Joseph Grossman. Yeah! Tiffany Joy Grossman. John Warren Heidenreich. Victoria Catherine Hicks. Peter A. Vinston. Michael S. Joyner. Mega V. Colwadwala. Kirk Knudsen. Mindy Lynn Lawrence. Jesse Paul Levy. Madison Littlefield. Annika Lockard. Brandon Michael Lohman. Eric B. Lundberg. Kyle Austin Markward. Matthew Mangy. Ariana Danielle Myers. Rujako Musa. Rujako will also receive her hood for successfully completing the Master of Business Administration degree. Evan Andrew Nelson. Nicholas H. Nelson. Kathleen Neufeld. Barbara Ann Olds. Kylie Michelle Overson. David A. Owens. Charles Pegg. Ethan W. Roseboom. Jessica Lee Salyers. J. Sandoval. Jordan Lee Sellinger. Robert L. Silva. Derek K. Steiner. Rachel Lynn Stokes. Darren Michael Stork. Jeffrey Robert Strom. Chelsea Lauren James Suderman. Nathan James Swihovic. Robert Christopher Valley. Chalice Dern Williams. Allison Ray Wimfeimer. Clinton J. Yandell.
Thank you, President Schaefer, for doing us the honor of conferring the Juris Doctor degrees on the members of the School of Law class of 2016. Wilma Mankiller, the first female chief of the Cherokee Nation, once said, "America would be a better place if leaders would do more long-term thinking." Here at the University of North Dakota, we are grateful that our short-term president has led us in long-term thinking. President Schaefer has a great deal of leadership experience, having served as governor of our state for two terms, as well as the United States Secretary of Agriculture under President George W. Bush. Here at UND, President Schaefer took on an interim role at a critical point in the university's progress. He has worked to achieve a sustainable budget, to identify and support key priorities, and to improve open communication on campus. And with all of that on his plate, he has still found time to visit regularly with students, including giving a guest lecture in a law school class this spring. President Schaefer, we are very glad to have you here, and we are very grateful for your support of North Dakota's law school. Please join me in welcoming President Ed Schaefer.
Thank you, Dean Rand. Thank you for all the opportunity to be here. Thanks for the warm welcome. And thank you for having us in this auditorium, because I was able to walk over here this morning. And when I walked over here, I thought, this is a great day in America. What a beautiful day in North Dakota and here on campus, and what an exciting time it is to be with you to confer your degrees. I was thinking about what you now take with you as you leave the university. And I was thinking of the heritage that we have here. My grandfather emigrated from Denmark. When he was 19 years old, he made his way out to these prairies. Actually, he didn't quite make it. His boat sank on the way. And fortunately, there was another ship that was close. They fished him out of the water. And the question was, do you want to go back to Denmark or go forward to America? And he said, I'm not going back. I'm going forward. And I'm going to America because that's going to be my new home. And this, as he made his way to North Dakota and planted a new farm and a new way and a new family, he tied into the traditions that were here in this very place in 1883, when a band of pioneers put a stake in the ground and said, we're going to provide education and honor and character for the people of this area. It wasn't a state yet even then, but they understood. And my grandfather understood at 19 years old when he enrolled himself in first grade, because he knew the power of education and the power of knowledge, and he wanted to be a part of that as he made his new way. When he landed here in America, because he had lost everything on the ship, he had with him the clothes on his back, 6 cents in his pocket, and this very ring that I wear today. And I wear this ring to remind me of that heritage and what he learned and what he was a part of here as he worked his way in his life in our state. He absorbed the characteristics of North Dakota, the work ethic and the moral courage, the frontier justice, the perseverance and the resourcefulness that we carry. As Carla said, the generosity and the kinship and the fortitude and the humility of North Dakota. Those characteristics are transferred to the University of North Dakota, and they now have been given to you. When I graduated from the University of North Dakota in 1969, I wasn't really aware of the foundational strength that those characteristics gave to me as I moved forward. But as I moved into a life of public service, a life of private sector experience, I soon learned that those strengths of my knowledge and of my character that came from the University of North Dakota, what allowed me to perform and allowed me to move to heights that were never imaginable. Certainly my grandpa would have never expected it, and many of my fellow students at UND at the time would not have even thought that I would have been able to get to the heights that I was able to achieve, but I did because of this university and of what I learned here and absorbed here. It is that character and that heritage now that you get to go forth with. Don Morton mentioned, as you leave this university, take with you innovation. Take with you the strength to seek change. Seek the truth. Seek peace. Find someone to lend a helping hand. That is what UND is for. That is what you will live your lives for. That is the heritage of the state of North Dakota, the heritage of UND, the heritage of the University of North Dakota School of Law. Embrace those foundational strengths. Use them as you go forth to present yourself to the world and go forth and do something great. And in that effort, I wish you Godspeed.
Thank you, President Schaefer. And thanks again to Dean Pratt and to the other participants in today's ceremony. Before we close, I want to give special thanks to the class of 2016. When you started law school, you arrived on campus in the middle of our planning for a major addition to and renovation of our law school building. The first major change to the law school building since the addition of the law library over 40 years ago. Then, for your second year, we moved out of the law school building so construction could start. You took classes and you met with faculty in temporary offices and classrooms across campus while the law school was under construction. During that challenging year, you showed patience, you showed good humor, and you showed grace. And we all grew to love the basement of Swanson Hall. And just as you started your third year, we moved into a beautiful new building on time and on budget. And you were among the very first students to reap the benefits of that historic investment in our state's law school. You are the only class to start in the old law school building and finish in the new and improved UND School of Law. Each of you, more than any other student or graduate, knows just how much the building project transformed our law school, transformed how we teach, transformed how we learn, and transformed how we built connections and community in our law school. So thank you, class of 2016, for your patience. Thank you for your good humor. And most of all, thank you for your help in getting us to where we are today, a new and improved UND School of Law that we are all so proud of. There will never be another graduating class like you. As our commencement ceremony comes to a close, we have a few folks to thank. The music that has so nicely enhanced today's ceremony has been provided by Brent Hermans. Our ceremony has been made more accessible thanks to Kathy Obregon, our sign language interpreter. And the careful coordination of our ceremony has been ably handled by Fred Whitman and Don Botsford. At the School of Law, many folks contributed to the success of today's ceremony and our other commencement events. I'd like to mention the hard work and gracious planning of Rob Carolyn, our Director of Alumni and Public Relations, Kelly Jordette, our Support Administrator, Beth Moe, our Events Coordinator, and Brad Parrish, our Assistant Dean for Student Life. Please join me in expressing our gratitude for all of their efforts in making this an enjoyable and memorable event. Immediately following this morning's ceremony, the School of Law will host a brunch for all of our graduates and their guests at the Memorial Union Ballroom. The brunch will begin as soon as we're done here, so please make your way to the Union immediately after the ceremony. The Memorial Union is located a few blocks to the east of here on University Avenue. The main entrance doors on University Avenue will be open, and the ballroom is located on the second floor. You and your guests who are driving to the Memorial Union are encouraged to park in the parking ramp on the corner of Columbia Road and 2nd Avenue. You can just tell the parking attendant as you enter the ramp that you are attending the law school brunch, and you get to park for free. If you have members in your party that have a difficult time getting around, you can drop them off in front of the Union prior to parking your vehicle. Our brunch will feature a short program. After you have a chance to mingle and enjoy a trip through the buffet line, we'll begin a program that celebrates the achievements of the class of 2016. The highlight of our brunch program will be an honor song played by the Northern Lights Drum Group to honor our graduates, as well as the friends and families in the entire School of Law community. And after the brunch, please feel free to ask your graduate to show you around the new and improved UND School of Law, which is right next door to the Union. Our pomp and circumstance will continue as we leave the auditorium. Our commencement marshals will lead the recessional in the reverse order of the entrance procession. So please stay in your seats until indicated by the marshals, which will be after the platform party and the graduates have exited. Once again, I thank you for joining us today, and I offer my own congratulations to our newest School of Law alumni, the class of 2016. We are very proud of each and every one of you, and we can't wait to see what you will achieve next.